The world is watching events in Afghanistan with a heavy heart and deep distress about what lies ahead. We have seen images of real-time chaos, unrest, uncertainty, and fear from what the future will unfold. Afghans witnessed a generation-long war and hardships due to various interventions from authorities that wanted to exploit it for their own imperial gains. Taliban is a fundamentalist group that emerged in the 1990s in southern Afghanistan. It drew a lot of members towards it, who, with support from the United States, repelled Soviet forces in the mid-1990s. However, by the late 1990s, Taliban gained control over most of the parts of Afghanistan. In 2001, after the attacks on the World Trade Center, the Taliban was driven out from power by the US troops. Throughout this, Afghans witnessed death, destruction, and chaos unparalleled in human history. On coming into existence, the Taliban promised to restore peace and security and enforce their own strict interpretation of Sharia law in Pashtun areas balancing Pakistan and Afghanistan. Taliban's rise to power must be seen in the context of the US intervention. In the recent happenings, the Afghan National Army, which has been actively funded by the US Empire for 2 decades, stood still as the Taliban retook the country in a couple of days. The Afghans feel betrayed by the global community as they are left at the mercy of Taliban. Women, children, and marginalized communities are suspected of bearing the brunt of this mishap. As Mullah Baradar of the Taliban greets Alvida to Ashraf Ghani, the West-approved Viceroy of Afghanistan, the sheer compliance of the US government is pretty visible in this peaceful deal. The failure of the government collapsed all sense of normalcy in Kabul as the president fled the country. While the elites were able to leave the nation, the working classes are in desperate need of aid. With all the countries evacuating their citizens and diplomats from Afghanistan, the future of the Afghan people looks uncertain. Under the Taliban's control, other extremist groups like ISIS established a foothold. During the evacuation, Kabul airport witnessed a terrific terrorist attack that took the lives of at least 70 people, including 13 US troops. The Taliban has formed a new government in Kabul led by Mohammad Hassan. With the help of Pakistan's ISI, they have conquered Panjshir province, which was the last stronghold of their mercenary enemy. Now, Afghanistan is in complete control of the Taliban. It is a resurgence of a dark era in which Afghani civilians must navigate the brutalities, oppression, and authoritarianism of Taliban rule.